Moscow, guys. This is what you're gonna see.
So guys, we are actually traveling on the outskirts of Moscow. Where am I?
People actually live in Moscow. Let's see about the prices, living conditions, the apartments. Welcome to Moscow.
It's a mountain.
It's garbage.
She's gonna show you how real Russians live.
Is it life out of Moscow? People here crazy about business. Grandmother apartment, very old building maybe. So this jacket is okay for minus 25 degrees. People who is working in Moscow City, for them, it's nothing. So what is good here if I compare my life with living in a center? Yes, it's not real Russian because I don't drink alcohol.
The real Moscow. Gonna check out the apartment here.
Only my location, we have three gyms, free ice skating. So you don't see it. So maybe some people, they don't know. This is a district for military people. Here I can say depressive district. So this district for drinking people. People don't have time for living by Russian berries. You can see no sweets, no beer. People only working. We have very, very top quality cleaning water system. So cheap area, and some people get apartment for free.
Or nuclear reactor.
Got apartments, kids without parents. Also government support. Two people drink a lot and started to fight. Police will come.
There's hundreds and thousands, I don't know, probably millions of people, Moscovites, live in these type of areas. I don't know, will I survive going back to the center?
Guys, I'm really, really far away from city center. This is outside, this is called outside Zamkat, outside the Moscow that you all know, guys. And I'm traveling actually to meet with Anna Global Travel. She lives outside Zamkat, so it's like real Moscow, right? Real Moscow, guys. This is what you're gonna see. Awesome. But man, I'm a little bit scary. I have to go to... I've never been so far out of city central area. Well, travel here half an hour. And now, actually, I'm gonna continue with another line even further. This is a big city, guys. This is a... Moscow is a country within a country, some might say. I feel like I'm in maybe another city at minimum. This is far. It's up there. I'm gonna find out how's life. Zamkadam. That's the highway over there. This is true Russia. True Moscow. Here's where probably big number of people actually live. Hold up, I think this is my bus. I'm afraid, you know, I've never been so far. It's like a whole different world. Where am I? What is this place, guys? Now, in this video, guys, we are exploring the outskirts of Russia. Of Moscow, how people actually live in Moscow's in the outskirts, so-called Zamkadam. Let's see about the prices, living conditions, the apartments. Join in, guys, let's go.
All right, guys, this is Igor in Russia, and now I'm actually was invited by Anna Global Travel to her apartment here in the outskirts, so-called Zamkadam. And she's gonna show you how real Russians live, real Moscovites live, because real Russia, maybe many might say it's not Moscow. But anyways, guys, welcome to outside Moscow center, way outside Moscow center. Let's listen and see what is life in outskirts of Moscow city. And this is the view of your view of the city.
6 kilometers from Makat, and from left side we have a very, very big forest. So that's why I like my location. We don't need permission. You just take your equipment for barbecue, go to the left and do barbecue here. You can run very big forest.
It's a mountain.
It's garbage.
Ah,
Because in Moscow, prices depends on location. It's not so important what is your apartment is, but important location. For example, if we show Moscow, we have center, north, south, east, and west. Now we are on the east. At east is the cheapest location. Now we are on the east. And for example, apartment here cost 20,000 rubles per month. So, and before drinking, you need to shake it. Da, you can drink it with coffee. And because it's very expensive, it costs 300 rubles. Uh-huh. Normal milk, 50. Like this. Жиром, мне знаешь, сколько процентов? Но это fat, но это good fats. 10%, because normal milk...
Well, at least the coffee is drinkable. What is Moscow life in general? What's the differences between city center and other areas around city center and Zamkat?
Yes, actually it's a big difference also. We in Moscow have a joke, people who live in the center, they say, is it life out of Moscow? In Russian, есть ли жизнь за МКАДом? То есть, it looks like all life only in the center of Moscow, and за МКАДом out of Moscow, no life. And so, we here to show you that we have life. What is the difference? Because center, you have everything. Yes, the center of Moscow is very beautiful, very active. Moscow also, we say, like it's a business city. If we say St. Petersburg, it's a cultural city. There are a lot of theaters. Museums also we have the same in Moscow, but historically it happened like this. Yes, so Moscow always was business, and people here crazy about business. So, and that's why people prefer live more close to center, because it's you lose so much time for reaching center. For example, now I live here and you need 1 hour and a half to reach center. It's really a lot. So imagine if you go to work, so you spend every day 3 hours. Some people spend 4 hours per day just for transport. That's why people prefer live more close to center. And there are a lot of fashion supermarkets, fashion restaurants, fashion shopping malls. And people who live in the center, it's fashion people. And of course, people with money, because if we compare rent, it can be more than here. It's, how to say, in double or sometimes in three times more.
What's the price? What's the prices in the center?
In the center, like 50, 60, 60. So I used, I can compare, because I used to live in the center and I paid 60,000 rubles, the same apartment like this. Apartment like this cost 25,000 rubles, in the center 60,000.
How much, what other cost is there? There's a pay for communal service.
So in general, per month, people pay for this kind of apartment maybe 5,000 rubles. It includes water, a general heating system, it includes, and the standard people pay 5,000 rubles per month for communal.
Yeah, it's 20,000 around the rent.
Yes, rent, but you can see my apartment has very good remont. But if you and without this, it will be 20. But if you rent apartment with a good furniture, so this one, for example, can cost 35,000 rubles in this district. Yes, if I share for rent it, I can ask 35. It's also, you can see it has warm, I can control warm floor, because sometimes it could be cold outside, and if you need extra warm.
It depends on the month or the time of the year.
Yeah, yes, it depends, of course, if you... No, it depends also how many people live. So if you every day cleaning, using water, so... And extra we pay for electricity. I rented it just for one year, because I found a good job. But it was 2 hours for me to reach this place, and I must be in a center, in my job, 8:30 a.m. It's too much early. So I started to wake up 5 a.m. It's too much for me. I'm not a morning person. So that's why I rented for 1 year. Then I back here, because now I work online. And I go to university only three days per week, three times per week. Mm-hmm. So I don't need to live close. So I can live here.
Well, it's 60,000 in the center.
60, yeah. So of course you can pay less, but the apartment will be very old, like we say, grandmother apartment, very old building, maybe from 1950 year, yes, and it will be very small, old, without furniture. So yes, but it also will be minimum 35,000 rubles minimum, but will be not comfortable. Comfortable apartment minimum 50,000 rubles, 50. From 50, 60, 70 in Moscow center, in Moscow city, apartment cost 200,000 rubles per month, one room apartment. But people who is working in Moscow city, for them it's nothing. No, if you get 1 million rubles per month, so for you 200,000, nothing.
People live here for like 20,000.
Yeah, and most of people, they don't live alone, of course. They live like minimum two people, like in apartment like mine. For example, normally two brothers, yes, mm-hmm. or boyfriend and girlfriend. So they share rent, so and you pay 10,000 rubles.
What's the advantages of living here then? Mm-hmm. What are the good things? I see you have like a trash hill over there.
Gara Musara.
Do you have what services? Is the polyclinics here? Shopping malls in Russia is everywhere, mm-hmm. always, of course. But what about like polyclinics, schools, polyclinics? What else do you need? Police? I don't know. Mm-hmm. What else? Banks? Mm-hmm. Do you have it here?
Yeah, so I live Zamkadam out of Moscow, and my location is Vostok, east of Moscow. But of course, my district east not so good because it's not so clean. We have yes, a mountain of rubbish. But if you have opportunity, you can live in other districts. So it means that I prefer living out of Moscow. No, okay, this is one minus. Not so much clean air, but if, for example, you live in Zapad West, so the situation will be better. What is good here, if I compare my life with living in a center, I was living on Belyaeva, so I can say that, for example, what the life is much, much cheaper. We have here, because it's out of Moscow, big supermarkets like Ashan, OK, Globus, and also, if you have money, it's always good to keep it, right? That's why rich people, they have money because they can keep it. And I didn't like living in a center because everything was too much expensive. And everything was small. I like here space.
Yeah.
Big supermarket, you come and you buy everything, clothes, medicine, everything you can have in one place. Also, when I was in center, I was problem to buy this kind of stuff like тряпка for cleaning your house. So here you just go in one place and buy everything. Second, as you said, yes, here we have everything, also polyclinics, hospitals, kindergartens, schools, police offices. We have everything what you need for comfortable life. I don't see any problem. So, and I feel here very comfortable. And also we have forest, and forest help us to clean this air. So that's why it's not so terrible.
That's the reason why people live here, money and of course comfortability.
Yes, and it's good for living because it's calm. For example, when I was living in center, it was for me really 2 months I couldn't sleep because it was too much noisy. Also, like we have windows and we call it paket. How many pockets you have? So it could be 1, 2, 3. For example, my has 2. Standard window has 1. I mean, how it protect from your from noise? And also in that apartment, I also had 2, and it was because it was road, and in the center cars is driving, especially some police. Oh my God, it was so, it's not good for your nervous system. It's the best, you must sleep in calm place.
So what kind of people live here then?
Here it's...
And how many people is in this neighborhood, do you know?
Yeah, so for example, I can say that my father is a military, he's officer. Now he's retired, and that's why I live here, because this is a district for military people.
Am I in trouble? Foreigner from a not friendly country.
So we, our government support always military people, and they give apartments for free. People who is living here, it's people from military, because they got apartments here, and also here a lot of workers, because it's cheap, and people who is working like some taxi drivers, people who is building something. Buildings, construction workers, yes. No, so we have, every district has some people. For example, when I was living in center, it was academic district, because I'm teacher, and when I was working in Pushkin Institute, I was living in this district, and it was people, how to say, intelligent people and academic people. So, and of course, we can compare their life. So, and for example, in that district, people can be maybe here people sometimes, so they can drink something, alcohol, something like this. So, unfortunately, it happens. So, this is minus.
Yeah, this is where people actually drink, because you don't see that much in the city center.
So, this district for drinking people. No, I don't say that everyone drinking, because here people are always working, and you can see.
Drunk, yes. What kind of, what's the mentality here? Do people believe in the future? What's the right now? People who live here. Is there something common for them in their views for the future?
No, here I can say depressive district. I think maybe I'm only one happy person here. No, because you can imagine how people think if people working always. So they like the driver of truck, that big грузовик. So and he wake up 4 or 5 a.m. He go to his job and come back home 10 p.m. So every day working, and he has only one day off. So, and these people who is living here, people don't have time for living. People only working. So they working and sleeping. And I don't like this kind of life, because you can't go to the theater, you can't do vlogs, you can't travel. People can't do this, because they do very hard job. And when you have one day off, what you will do? You will do something for your house, maybe to repair something, to buy food. That's it, nothing. Or maybe go to some barber shop, minimum, at least. So that's why people, I think, not happy who is too much working, because we need to do something in our life, to meet people, to meet friends, go doing sport. A lot of life is very amazing, so many interesting things. We shouldn't always work. That's why people sometimes not very happy in this district.
Can you drink water from the kran?
Да, очень. Guys, very, very good question. So guys, you can see, it's very popular question from my foreign students. They always buy bottles of water, and I tell them, you can drink water from a kran. So it's, we can see. In Moscow, we have, also we can show in internet, we have a website of our mayor, and we can see on the screen the system. We have very, very top quality cleaning water system. So you can drink here. Also, you can see what I use. No, I use some double cleaning, so it's not necessary, but I just want it, because it will be more clean. So, and it's really cheaper, because, for example, I pay for this 5,000 rubles one time.
You have that stuff on
Yes, here. This stuff here, I pay just my 5,000 rubles, and every year I need to change and pay 2,000. So you can imagine my water cost 2,000 rubles per year.
Yeah, in Moscow you can drink water.
So you can see what I do.
I
can say only about Moscow, about, you can try. I can't say about other cities, I don't know.
In case there's a problem, you can have, you have polyclinic here.
Cheap area, and some people get apartment for free. like military, and also got apartments, kids without parents, also government support people. So when they grow, they have free apartments, so they don't pay.
That usually means that this area might have some problems because of the demographic.
Yes, but you know, Moscow is a very safe place also because of, and also this area when maybe people from not successful, how to say, families, also everything, good here. And if some conflict happens, like if for example two people drink a lot and started to fight, police immediately after 5 minutes will come. So I go safely, I come back home late at night, 3 a.m and nothing. Live here all my life in this district. I live 16 years. I said only about most of kind of people who's living here, but also there are living people who has more free time. And this district I like also because it has a lot of sport opportunities. For example, in only my location, we have 3 gyms. And for example, when I was living in the center, it was for me problem to find a gym, and the nearest gym from my house, it was 40 minutes walking. I don't use car. I can't drive, but I don't like using car, bus, and I always go by foot. And for example, from here to my gym, it's just 15 minutes. And also here we have free ice skating. So you can do skating, it's free. Пожалуйста. And you have a big forest when you can do skiing. And when I walk in the forest, I every day see a lot of people, families who is doing skiing. So this location is very good for sport.
So we have heard now about general life here in southeast of Moscow, the real Moscow, because here the real people, the ordinary people live here. Not everybody can afford minimum 60,000 per month. That's $600 basically. For Russia, that's a lot of money. 60,000 and as a minimum, probably near center. But anyways, I think you guys want to hear and see how Russians actually live also physically. We're going to check out the apartment here, and Anna is going to be taking a tour around her house. Let's get into it. And if you're new to the channel, remember to push likes already right now, because you're seeing real Russia. We are just guests here at the real Russian woman's Anna's house, and she's gonna tell us all.
So hello everyone again. So let me show you my apartment. So this is a typical corridor, so place when you come to apartment. Every apartment has this kind of thing, and here usually what we do, we undress. So I can show you, it's a life hack, not everyone knows. Oh, it
I did a mistake.
Ah, yes. So guys, this is life hack, because here in Moscow we have a lot of snow, and you can see this water, it stay here if you use it, because when you are undressed and if you put your shoes here, that will be water and you need to do extra cleaning. So I use this one. Also, this is my clothes. Very important for cold Russia. You can see I have long coat. Of course, I have a short if I wear it with jeans and if it's not so cold. But so this jacket is okay for -25 degrees. Yeah, so very, very warm. So here my scarf and so on. I decide, okay, why every year I dress and undress, decorate my house? Okay, let's decorate one time and don't change. So this is my mirror. When I dress, I always check here. This is for the dirty clothes. Yes, and also you can see my apartment is small, so that's why I don't have special room when I can keep this kind of stuff. So when I need to iron something, I open this and put it here. Here, this is my sport. I go to gym, but sometimes also I do every morning exercises. So this is my bathroom, and this is, okay, I don't know, Vadik's toilet. And
you, as a Russian, you don't notice, but Russian houses most oftenly have a bathtub, which mm-hmm. is very rare in the West, because it has to be, it's like a luxury product thing. In Russia, it's most of all, if there's a space for it, there will be a bathtub.
And this is for Vadik drinking. And also I have, you can see, because my apartment is small, mm-hmm. That's why I bought this kind of
smaller,
we call it vertical machine.
This is like, if I quickly show you, this is maybe This is maybe 40 at least.
No, I think no.
Before you continue, let's show.
This is Vadik's space. So this chair is special for him. So, and what is special in my apartment, because this is fake, it's not real. Originally, it was just one room. So it's
it's fake wall.
Fake wall, yes. And this fake wall makes two rooms. And the next room I will show you, it's my office. So this is my wardrobe. And here I keep my clothes, so only one. So, and now we are going to my office. Welcome. So this is a sofa, and you can see I also have desk. So you can see I'm very professional when my students also, they can come to me. So, and I have this desk, and when I do classes, for example, my students sit here and I teach him. So, and this is my books. So this space.
But so far it's quite, except maybe the office room, this is quite typical Russian apartment, more or less.
Yes, it's typical, but minus office, because I work online. And the kitchen, this is my kitchen, so I can show you my fridge. I don't say it's typical, it's typical.
Yeah, it's
yes, it's not real Russian, because I don't drink alcohol, so you don't see it. And you can see X, again X. So maybe some people, they don't know about this kind of X. A lot of vegetables. I eat fish, cheese, and a lot of this is some. I cook homemade juices. I don't buy juices in supermarket, so I buy Russian berries. Like
you do your own не компотка, морс.
Морс, yes, I do my own морс. So this is клюква.
Клюква is the best, I think.
Клюква и облепиха. So I cook by myself, so I can control sugar, I can add it or not. You can see no sweets, no beer. And of course for Vadik. And this is very tasty. He's also he's vegetarian, so it's joking. And also we have this one, second, it's for frozen food, if we buy.
It's the same as in the world, yes, Russian refrigerator is the same.
Yeah, the same?
Maybe you guys think that this is like a nuclear reactor, but no, it's the Russian normal, typical Russian small table for a typical this size type of kitchen.
Yes, yes, but and also of course if I live here alone, that's why I don't need a big table. Of course if the family is living, the table will be much bigger, but I usually eat alone, or if my brother come to me, or for example you, my guests, so for two people it's normal. Also here I can seat four people, so it's really,
yeah, you can just move it to another location.
Yeah, so no need a big one. And so here I keep some, you can see I drink a lot of tea, coffee, and I cook here.
Oven,
yeah.
And these are all standard from the 2000s.
No, it's expensive one, it's chaynik.
Yeah, for water.
For making tea,
yes.
The chaynik, for making a coffee. And this one, VC. So I can calculate how many calories I have. Mm-hmm. And this one, blender, if I need to do something smoothie. So very comfortable. It's a space for...
Mm-hmm. So that's basic stuff, right? So
yeah.
Basic stuff over here. A lot of space for a small-ish apartment.
It's really good apartment for one person. If two people live here, really will be not comfortable.
All right, guys, this was a unique visit to a real Russian neighborhood outside the Circle Highway of Moscow. We are actually in the very outskirts of the Moscow city. There's hundreds and thousands, I don't know, probably millions of people, Moscovites live in these type of areas outside the Zamkat. Mm-hmm. So we got to see how real Russians live. Big thank you to Anna Global Travel over here. You can click on the title and subscribe to her channel, because she shows you more of these type of stuffs, and also about learning Russian language, which is the key to a mm-hmm. culture. All right, thank you very much for having me here. I don't know, will I survive going back to the center from here? You said there are people live here that's dangerous, so I don't know. But if you don't hear about me, watch my other videos to remember me. Anyways, subscribe to the channel as well, and bye bye y'all from Moscow, Russia.
Bye for now.